Now, KSBW Weather with Carl Thormeyer.
Sky Command Soledad shows the extensive sky cover over our viewing area this morning. This is the view from 4,400 feet up, and as you see, the tops of the clouds are pretty high, almost to the tops of the hills across the way there. So let's take a look at the satellite picture and see just how bad it is. Well, this is the last 8 hours or so, and you can see toward the end there, there's clouds throughout the entire viewing area except over the highest peaks, and then south of about Point Sur, looks like it's clear along the coast. But other than that, it's pretty well overcast this morning. Now, not the low clouds that we're used to seeing in the summertime, but more like clouds as you would expect in the winter half of the year sometimes in this kind of a weather pattern. Temperatures right now are moving up pretty quickly, already 57 degrees in Watsonville. Didn't get much below 50 last night in most areas. And if we take a look at the temperatures as we go up in elevation, well, 54 at sea level in Capitola, 47 at 1,250 feet in the Santa Cruz Mountains, and 41 degrees at 2,600 feet. So that's a fairly steep temperature gradient from the surface to 2,600 feet. And as a result, we do have those clouds covering our area this morning. Now, in fact, Microcast paints this picture pretty well. Here's Monterey Bay right here. We're going to see what Microcast does with these clouds. It actually pulls them back, and by 2 o'clock this afternoon is right along the coastline. So I'm optimistic we'll see a lot of sun most areas this afternoon. Now tonight, it doesn't bring the low clouds back in that far. I think it probably will go further than this, but it's pretty optimistic, a little more optimistic than I think it ought to be. But it does pull the clouds back again tomorrow for sunshine. But then by Tuesday morning, we're going to have more clouds and low clouds and fog heading down the Salinas Valley. So that's about what we would expect this time of year. And temperature-wise, pretty cool. 60 in San Francisco, upper 60s in the South Bay. All these temperatures are below normal for this time of year. We're looking at low to mid-70s in the Santa Clara Valley, and we'll go from mid-60s in Salinas to mid-70s at King City, maybe upper 70s down around Bradley. And over in the Monterey Peninsula, only temperatures only pushing 60 degrees, some upper 50s there. So a very cool day. And Santa Cruz Mountains in the mid-60s and along the coast about the same as well. So not bad at all. And we'll talk next time about how hot it is in the rest of the country. But on the bay, quieted down a lot from yesterday. 2 to 5 feet of surf we're forecasting out there, and 3 to 6 feet of swell. And here's what it looks like from the Embassy Suites and Seaside, our SkyCam 8. And you can see those waves are a lot lower than they were yesterday. So we're going to say we're going to have mostly cloudy this morning, with clearing back to near the coast by roughly noontime. Some areas near the coast may not see the sun today. And then low clouds back in again to the valleys tonight. And then tomorrow I think we'll have clearing a little bit earlier, more sunshine. So that's good news. And looking at the 7-day, this is the inland forecast for high temperatures. You see we could hit low 90s in the south end of the Salinas Valley by Thursday. And along the coast, though, it'll warm up a little bit, but still mostly in the 60s to low 70s throughout the week. So we'll have low clouds most every day, just variation, you know, as it is in the summertime. So.
Okay. All right. Great. Thank you, Carl.